So hello everyone and welcome back to another video. Today we are going to look at Notion versus Loop, and I want to talk about how Loop is different to Notion, and I want to talk through some of the reasons why you might err on the side of Notion right now as a collective experience. So here we are inside of our Notion account. Now, one of the things that you'll obviously get from the get-go is that Notion does have a lot of capabilities. We know that I would say probably the database function is largely the most powerful feature in this, and it can extend quite fast. So I want to talk about that first. As you can see, this is a database that we use for content writing and things like that. And you can go into quite a high level of depth here. You can see not just properties that are part of each database, but filters, sorting, grouping, subsorting, even subtasks, layouts on multiple levels, and lots of different customization. If you directly compare that to the feature that's available inside of Microsoft Loop right now, it's vastly different because you get some very basic sorting, some very basic column abilities, and you can see you can change column type here, and it's very simplistic in its structure. It's not going to be doing vast views, vast setups like this. And I think that's the primary difference between Notion and the likes of Loop. And obviously we've got here, this part is sort of like the canvas experience, is they're very similar in a lot of ways. Obviously you can't do the great deal of functions like slash command and using certain blocks to create. You can't create pages and you can't do a lot of this mass multimedia stuff and creating databases and buttons and breadcrumbs and synced blocks and all this sort of jazz. But you can do a lot of what it does already. It's quite simplistic in a sense where they've laid the groundwork for the basics. But the difference between this element, the tables function, and Notion is vastly different. Like, they're gonna have to do a lot of catching up. The core difference, I think, is that Loop is very much structured to be a little bit more less, I guess, flexible than Notion. With Notion, you've literally got unlimited flexibility with the databases. Like here, if you wanted to do a voting option, you are reliant on the team at Microsoft releasing new functions for this and sort of giving you more capabilities. Whereas at Notion, you do have a lot more. The key difference between Loop and Notion is this element, and that's the Loop experience. So obviously with this, you can turn anything into a Loop component. So if I want to turn this into a Loop component, I can create it, and naturally I can share and extend it. Obviously, one thing you could do in Notion is create a linked database and share it with people. Obviously, there would be some limitations to the workspace, but largely you could do something like that. You could make it shareable. But the difference that I think a lot of people are finding is that if I were to share something with Notion, it still requires you to go into links and to actually interact with those links. Whereas, I'm sure Steve will show it on screen as we're speaking, the Loop components actually go between that. So you can use it in Microsoft Teams, anywhere really, literally any Microsoft 365 platform that has the Loop component capability to do that, which is very different. And it sort of breaks that barrier between using a component actively and not. So imagine being able to send something to somebody and then being able to interact with a database of Notion without them having to go into a link and to be able to view it in guest mode or anything like that. There is that step that can really be ironed out. Now I want to talk about that a little bit because Loop components are the only saving grace for Loop, in my opinion. But at the same time, is this a problem that we're fixing, or is it a problem that we're creating? Like, with Loop components, are do people really need this? Do people really need to interact in real time in these areas? And I think the answer is yes. I think having real time collaboration without having to go into areas is really helpful. But I think the largest problem will actually be sorting them and making sure that you are aware of where they are. And this is where I think Loop as a platform like this exists. And the reason it exists is because you need a place to store and organize all of these. Whereas before, Loom components could exist and be able to be collaborative, but they would only be available in those collaborative spaces and they wouldn't really have a home. This is a home for your Loom components. That's the way I view it at the moment. So other aspects of it, I think workspaces are nice inside of Loom, and that sort of, I would say that team spaces are probably a lot smarter in their sense, like in the structure. And you've got workspaces as well up here. I just think overall, the entire package of Notion is considerably better. Everything from down to templates, down to the ability to structure stuff is so flexible. And I think Microsoft will probably do a few things. And the first of those is they will build on what Notion has as a core Loom experience. Like, for example, making this a lot better to manage and easier to manage. So that's number one. The second is advancing these tables, probably, in being a lot more capable, viewing a lot more different styles, because at the moment you've only got table and this task-like view. So being able to correct that or make them more enhanced will be something that they do. And number three is probably make it a lot easier for the admins to switch Microsoft Loom on. Right now, Microsoft Loom is switch on only and you have to be an admin. So that's something that can be a little bit of a barrier to entry, especially when they've got the distribution they have. It's probably just because, you know, like a lot of the plans probably don't include Loom. So it's like trying to make sure that they future-proof themselves if they want to remove Loom from a plan and move it to another plan. But I do think that's almost the issue right now, is they almost need to go, okay, we need to make Loom part of our larger system and sort of commit to it and actually get admin set up. If you're somebody that is looking to activate loop.microsoft.com, then you can find out videos from Daryl as a service. He does Modern Work Mentor. I'll put him linked below. He has some good videos and content about how to make sure you switch on admin properly for you and your team. But largely, it's, I would say at the moment, it's almost uncomparable. If they didn't have Loom components, Notion wouldn't even be worrying about these guys, because Microsoft and Google, these big companies, have the mindset sometimes of just switching them off and not really taking advantage of them. So I think Microsoft Loom has a lot of potential, but if it develops fast and it rapidly improves this experience, the actual structure experience of the account and the feature functions that that comes within it. One of the things that even like when they pre-launched, they had like this feature where it was like video notifications where you could reply back with video notification. But they dropped that for launch, which makes total sense because obviously it's quite a lot of information. But that's the sort of features that are going to differentiate from Notion, is that sort of like, you know, that sort of step forward that they might need to take a little bit of risk on if they're going to leapfrog. But obviously Microsoft Loom isn't going for the smaller audiences like Notion is. They're going for medium to large teams. But in the sense, Notion could also take a lot of hints from this. Like, there is this area private down here, but they could have area for the ideas and recent. That's a really nice feature. And I guess linked databases is sort of similar to this, but you could develop some sort of Loom component element as part of Notion if it's something that teams are looking to enhance. Like, I'm not sure how you can do it. It's mainly because 365 and Teams and all that are built for this. So you're sort of building something that works in a system you've already got. But I feel like Notion should be thinking about how they can approach being more widely accessible. But again, only because this problem's come up that they've created. So it might not even be a problem. Anyway, folks, I hope you found this video useful. I thought it was a fun overview of just where my opinions are with Loom versus Notion right now, giving you a bit of a side-to-side comparison of how it works. At the moment, we've got a few videos. We've got Microsoft Loom in depth that we've done that I'm sure we'll be posting on the other channel. And I'm sure you can find that there. But aside from that, this was just an overview of my thoughts of where things stand at the moment. So folks, hopefully you enjoyed this one. I look forward to seeing you subscribe, and I'll see you in a next video, I'm very sure. Cheerio.